Today, we are going to introduce another new VR camera from Insta360, the Insta360 EVO. The EVO is a 5.7K VR 180 camera with the ability to turn into a regular 360 camera, become a 1X replacement. If you follow my channel on all the VR 180 camera review, the EVO seems to be a little late in the game. But Insta360 bring in some new feature that none of the other competitors have. Besides flow state stabilization and HDR video in VR 180, EVO come with a phone cover called Naked Eyes right here. Will instantly turn your phone into a eye tracking 3D viewing devices, so you can share your excitement with your friends and family immediately without VR headset or complicated post-production. Insta360 also make VR 180 post-production a lot easier. With the brand new Insta360 Studio 2019, it works great with the amazing YouTube VR 180 Creator 2 and can be directly uploaded onto both YouTube and Facebook and Oculus Go or Samsung Gear VR headset for 5.7K 3D 180, the highest resolution possible. Let's dive right in and take a detailed look at the camera and how it's built. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Bringing It Up. I am in my hotel room in Abu Dhabi working on a 360 live streaming job for a really big international client right now. So, you don't see my regular kitchen background right there. I am a 360 VR professional, not just a YouTuber. So all my knowledge come from my hands-on experience as a DP or DIT. Why I am obsessed with camera technology. Understanding the ins and out of any VR camera, it is a crucial part of my work. But let's back to our focus for today, the Insta360 EVO. The spec is almost identical to Vue's XR, but a lot smaller and lighter. 5.7K VR 180 is the highest of consumer VR 180 camera. The IPD distance of this thing is about 2.6.2, so pretty standard. But let's talk about the image quality. Instead of listen to me talk, I will invite you to watch my VR 180 video dev film with the EVO. Click the top right corner here for the link to the video. You should watch it in YouTube VR with your Oculus Go headset or my Facebook version in Facebook 360 app inside Oculus Store. You cannot really see 3D 180 without a VR headset. Judging from my test video, the image quality is good. 5.7K look a lot better than CoolCam or Lenovo Mirage 4K. I will make a comparison video next to Vue's XR to see which one is better in 5.7K. EVO has a lot mode and HDR mode for video, just like 1X right here. So it is a lot more gradable and post-production friendly. It has generally better dynamic range and lock, so you can bring back more detail as you see in this video. Just be careful if it is low light, don't use lock mode. It brings in noise and hard to recover lost color. Another great feature is flow state stabilization. It is available as well in VR 180. As you see my video, like VR 180 vlogging really work in this camera. I would say it is noticeable better than other VR 180 cameras, and I still highly recommend keep your camera level with a handheld gimbal if you can. It is a 360 camera as well, and shoot the same spec as 1X. It is a 1X replacement. It has all the features you love in 1X, HDR photo and video, DNG RAW photo, time-lapse photo, and video with a minimal of 1 second interval, and etc. The switch is very, very easy. You push the lock right here, untie it, lock it the other way. Now you have a 5.7K 360 camera and it's really small and light. I think the design is better than views as well because there's no spring involved, so it will not change the stereo stitching. What really set EVO apart from other VR warranty camera is not the spec or the image quality. It is actually the phone editing app and the light preview app that let you see what you just captured immediately in 3D with a camera phone with eye tracking technology, Naked Eye 3D, with a special phone case right here called Insta360 HoloFrame. By simply flip the phone case and slap it on the actual display screen like this and hit preview in HoloFrame, the app will walk you through to preview your footage in 3D, which really make you see deeper as they advertise in their launching campaign. They also build their own Oculus app called Insta360 VR to view VR 180 footage directly on Oculus Go or Samsung Gear VR, which is a nice touch. I will save the workflow in the next EVO tutorial, but it's really easy. You can shoot, edit, finish all within your phone and directly into VR headset with optimized headset performance, which is pretty crazy. Let's talk about a thing that you need to watch out for before buying this camera. It is about $420, just a little bit more than the 1X, but if you don't care about VR 180, I would still suggest you stick to the 1X. Check out my Insta360 1X review right here. The reason why is the stitch line. The EVO, when you flow back, is a lot thicker than the 1X as you see right here. So it is harder to stitch in a physical distance. You need to stand a lot further around the stitch line area like right here to avoid stitching issue. But even then, as you see my walking demo here in 360, the stitch line is clearly visible. Even though you have no idea how I hold the EVO, the invisible selfie stick. 3D stereo stitching is a big software weakness in Insta360 product in general. Their professional light camera, Insta360 Pro or Pro 2, still has vertical parallax, which is considered as bad stereo. Stereo that make people sick in VR headset. Sam goes with the EVO right here. If you see my VR 180 video, you will clearly see vertical parallax in distant objects, which should have no parallax at all. The parallax is getting worse if flow state is involved and the camera is not level. That is why I would suggest using a handheld gimbal to lock the horizon line for practical use. EVO, one advantage is it's so light. It will fit on literally any small affordable phone gimbal. Also, all stereo parallax issue can be easily fixed with the third-party finishing tool like Messica VR. Check out this tutorial for more information. VR 180 is a brand new exciting world of filmmaking. A lot of Hollywood filmmakers are starting to experiment with VR 180 filmmaking. It is great to see the biggest VR camera player, Insta360, invest in VR 180. Make it more affordable and more consumer friendly. I also hope Creator Up can become your go-to source for anything VR 180, as I work closely with Google, Facebook, and camera makers to create ongoing tutorials, workflow improvement for 3D 180. We have a whole playlist dedicated to VR 180 post-production, so go check it out. In the next video, we will compare the Views XR, Lenovo Mirage, Kendall Coolcam, and Insta360 EVO. The reason why I have not done the Views XR comparison is because of EVOs. Now all the big players are out. We can really drill down which camera is better for you in VR 180. I will see you in VR in the next video.